Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome. So in today's video, I'm actually going to be doing a comparison video. I haven't done this in a while. And I'm going to be comparing two mainstream polishes that, in my mind, were very similar. But as soon as I got the bottle out to compare, I realized that they weren't. So this is Essie's Watermelon and Cajun Shrimp from OPI. These are classic mainstream polishes that I do believe you can still get anywhere. I recently got the Essie Watermelon because of Hey Mercedes here on YouTube and on Instagram. And when I put it on, the first thing I thought of was it reminds me of Cajun Shrimp from OPI. And I kept saying that. And now that I pulled out OPI's Cajun Shrimp to actually do the comparison, they're not the same at all. The camera is showing the Essie a little bit redder. It did that when I took my pictures of the Essie polish as well. It just pulls a little bit more of the red. The Essie Watermelon is more like a raspberry pink kind of color, a little bit, I don't know, almost magenta-y, but not really. And the Cajun red, for me, I actually have it in my corals because to me, when I put it in my reds, I see it more as a coral. And then when I put it in my corals, it kind of leans a little red, but still kind of fits in a way. I wanted to see if I zoomed in, if you could see the differences in the polishes that you can't really quite see it on camera. So I zoomed you in so that you can maybe it would pick up the little nuances that the polishes have. I don't know if you can tell, but definitely the OPI leans more red than the Essie. Even by itself, I feel like, see, it looks like it's pulling a little bit more red on camera, but it is a raspberry pink color. But then you bring in the OPI and it immediately lightens this up. Both of them are beautiful polishes, perfect for spring, summertime, and I don't know, I just love them. So we're gonna do some swatching comparison. We're gonna get started with the Essie Watermelon. And for me, it was perfectly opaque at two coats. I did not need anything more than two coats. Honestly, it could almost be a one coater, but this is Essie's Watermelon at one coat. The formula is fantastic. Again, this camera is pulling so much red for this polish. It's insane, but it is, in real life, it is a raspberry pink color with a little bit of redness in it. It's fantastic. It looks so pretty. I did not realize how much I was gonna love this color. Next, we're gonna do OPI Cajun Shrimp, one coat of that. The OPI Cajun Shrimp formula is a little bit more sheer than the Essie's Watermelon. And as you can tell, even on this swatch at one coat, it's pulling a little bit more orangey. That's where I feel like the coral kind of color comes up with OPI's Cajun Shrimp. I still like it. It's beautiful. It's one of my favorite polishes to wear, especially as a pedicure. I'm actually wearing Watermelon as a pedicure right now. I took off Watermelon and put on the manicure that I have on my nails right now, but then I had to still wear Watermelon again and wore it as a pedicure. So it is, both of these colors are fantastic as pedicures. I am going to let this dry a little bit and then do the second coat off camera and then come back with the final results. All right, so here we go with the final results. This here is Essie's Watermelon and OPI Cajun Shrimp. They are so not similar. I mean, if you are a nail polish collector, I would highly recommend having these two in your collection because it is a collection. You like having them and they are different enough to be able to tell a difference. But a regular person who just like casually likes nail polish is not going to notice much of a difference. I asked my husband if he can see a difference between these two and he's like, no, they're just red. And I was like, they're not red. He's like, okay. So yeah, so this here, like I said before, this is Essie's Watermelon. It is such a beautiful pink. Again, it keeps pulling a little bit red for me, but it is not red at all. It is definitely a raspberry pink, juicy polish. Oh, it's so pretty. It looks very juicy. And if you've been with me before, you know I'm not one for creams most of the time, but I love this shade. It's so pretty. And then here we have OPI's Cajun Shrimp, which is pulling really orange compared to how it normally looks in my mind. I don't remember it pulling this orange before. It's beautiful. They're both beautiful. I would say, do you need them both? If you're a collector, yes. If you like having mainstream polishes that are iconic, then yes. But honestly, no, not really. If you are just a want something for the summer, and either one of these, it depends on your preference, to be honest. They're not dupes at all. Not as much as I was saying in my comments on my post when I wore Essie's Watermelon on Instagram. But it did remind me. It just reminded me when I first put it on, just because I felt that same way about OPI Cajun Shrimp, where I put it on and it kind of just took my breath away. And it is a very juicy polish, and it's one of my favorite to wear. Now, if I had to choose a favorite polish right now, I would say it's the Essie Watermelon. I like it a little bit better than Cajun Shrimp, mostly because Cajun Shrimp is pulling so orange, and even though I like corals, I like pink leaning corals more than orange leaning corals. But honestly, if Essie's Watermelon was not here, like if you could just see this polish, I think, I don't know, it's hard because this is like, they're both so beautiful. But I know that I love Cajun Shrimp. I know that I love it. And once I put it on, I'm gonna fall in love with it all over again, as I always do when I wear this. But right now, I like seeing them together. I prefer the Essie Watermelon more than the OPI Cajun Shrimp. All right. Thank you everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Let me know in the comments down below if you have both of these polishes, which one is your favorite, or do you even have a favorite? Can you not choose between them? Because I totally get that too. And before I let you all go, I forgot to mention that the polish that I'm wearing on my fingers right now is Bee's Knees Lacquer in Liar, and I did do some reverse stamping with this polish. Thank you everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.